upset. She did so against Priscilla Hertati Lumbangol in Priscilla's backyard. Can she derail the hype of Stamp Fairtex in Stamp's backyard here in Bangkok? Stamp Fairtex, world Muay Thai champion, world kickboxing champion, has her sights set on becoming a world mixed martial arts champion. Pujatoma will want to test her wushu striking against the Muay Thai of Stamp. Stamp has the height, has the reach. Pujatoma's got to get off those side kicks, those rapid fire hand combinations. Stamp taking her time, seeing what the Indian is made of, testing her mettle.
Stamp Fairtex predicts a head kick KO of Pujatoma, and she's starting to set that up now, but that was a beautiful little catch. Redirect, put Stamp Fairtex on her back, but she pops right back up. Pujatoma needs to keep doing that. She needs to put Stamp down, make her work. Oh, she gives up her back as she tried to sweep right there. She tried to catch and sweep, but she gives up her back, and now Stamp is on her back looking for that rear naked choke. So it's not quite a choke yet. You can still squeeze on both sides of the artery and still finish, but that's a high-level choke. And I don't know if Stamp Fairtex has that type of technical capability, but if she keeps working on it, she could start to slowly inch that arm underneath the chin of Pujatoma.
Stamp Fairtex trying to lock the figure four around the body to no avail, though. This is the fourth mixed martial arts contest for Stamp Fairtex. She's 3-0. Pujatoma comes in 4-3. The fourth time champion still has the two-sport world champion on the back. Here comes Stamp. This crowd going bananas. Every time she lands something, they scream for Stamp Fairtex. Tries to flip her out like an Indian pancake. Stamp in control. Gonna get the full mount. Yes, she does. Drops the ground and power. Stamp Fairtex choosing her mark. Trying to open her up to land.
Stamp Fairtex, as she able to sit up, posture up, grabs the back of the head, watch those right hands start to come.
The evolution of Stamp Fairtex has been phenomenal over the last 18 months. Look at this again, composition on Toma, dropping the elbows from a vertical position. Spins around Stamp Fairtex, heads on one way traffic, takes her back again. Unstuffing it! Stamp Fairtex, a house on fire!
Submissions by extending those arms like that. She's got to create some kind of scrambles because right now she's given a bad position after bad position.
Toma not defending. Referee Olivia Cole straight on top of the action. Here comes Stamp trying to finish her. Is Olivia Cole going to stop it? Toma not defending. Stamp continues to punish her. Smack back to the kisser. Smack back between the eyes. The left hand. The power. Now the right hand switch. Inside the circle, mixed martial arts for Stamp Fairtex and Asher Roker. Look at the hands on Roker, look at the kicks on Stamp Fairtex.
And also there's been opponents that have tried to shoot in on Roker to try to take her off her feet, and she's been able to finish them with a guillotine. She's got a very tight guillotine, so pay close attention if Stamp does try to decide to shoot in on her.
Good check there from Stamp Fairtex.
The plan
planted flag in the center of the circle here, Stamp Fairtex. Asheroga looking for a chance to get on the inside and fire away with those hands. Catches the kicking there, catches with the hands there, the knees from Asheroga. Stamp Fairtex! Oohs and ahs for the crowd here in Bangkok.
Stamp able to connect on one of those knees inside the clinch. Roka's got to be careful.
They will go into a meltdown if Stamp Fairtex knocks out Asheroga. Probing jab, inside thigh kick from Stamp. Roka circling away from the power side. The kickboxing and Muay Thai world champion. One of over 140 martial arts world champions on the ONE Championship roster. Good leg kick there from Stamp Fairtex. No ground game so far. Roka biding her time. Jab to right hand there from the Indian boxer. Undefeated. Thanks here from Stamp Fairtex. Don't forget to follow ONE Championship across all social media. On YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
Beautiful body lock takedown right now in side control. Roka's got to switch her hips. She's got to change and face Stamp and get onto her left side right now. You can see Stamp's got that side control. Steps easily over into mount.
Full mount for Stamp Fairtex. She tries to bust it up and work the ground and pound. Here comes Fairtex. This crowd going bananas. The full mount for Stamp Fairtex. Measures her with the ground.
Roka's trying to exit out the back door, trying to lace those legs around. She might be able to slide out the back here. That she does, but Stamp transition, still maintaining side control.
And mounts her for a second time. Asheroga on her back, 2 minutes remaining, first round. It's all Stamp Fairtex at the moment. Controlling Stamp's posture, not allowing the two-sport world champion to posture up around the ground. Is she going to give it back? No. Stamp still has the mount. That is a hand fist drop. And again, wraps the hands around the back of the head. Pulls Stamp Fairtex down towards her chest.
You can see a little bit of inexperience on the ground here from Roka. Well, she's got to try to let go of that head, start pushing down on the legs, or at least start bucking the hips up like that. Just to clear a little bit of space in that movement, but you can see how Stamp's got her legs great behind her. Legs are Roka, and she's applying that pressure with her hips. It's going to be very hard for Roka to bump out of that.
Stamp Fairtex wants to send a message to the Atomweight division in mixed martial arts here at ONE Championship. She's the queen of kickboxing, the queen of Muay Thai, and her aim is simple. She says, I want to be a three-sport world champion. She postures up again.
Put her on her back, and then this was just an onslaught. Stamp on top, just dropping heavy ground and pound, controlling the head, pushing down the face of Roca.
A big hello to Rich Franklin watching this one, watching his discovery from One Warrior Series, Stamp Fairtex.
Stamp looks spectacular in that first round. How does Roca make the adjustments? First adjustment she needs to make is stay away from the ground. She looks like a fish out of water on the ground right there. So she's got to make sure she keeps this on the feet. Keep circling, keep that distance, utilize that jab. But when you're on the feet, that's the Muay Thai and kickboxing queen, Michael Cerrone.
Confidence oozing out of every pore of Stamp Fairtex. This crowd in absolute frenzy for their darling Stamp Fairtex. Roca's got to get a chance to throw hands. This one brought to you by Global Citizen. Circling away from the power side of Stamp Fairtex. Patience here from Stamp. A pump kick there from Roca. Dominator on the ground in the opening round was the Indian. Jab from Roca, edging away on the inside here. There's the right hand, getting at the distance. Tries to counter the leg kick. The intensity in the eyes of Stamp Fairtex tonight. She takes a solid right hand and the power's back. And the chance wins up. Stamp, Stamp, Stamp inside the sold-out Impact Arena.
As dominant as Stamp was in that, those ground, those grappling exchanges, I would expect her to be shooting for a takedown here pretty soon, but we know just how comfortable she is on the feet, and she seems to be reading Roca pretty well.
Stamp smiles at the lady they call the knockout queen.
But Roca is able to connect on some of these punches, and this is a little glove, so she's got to be careful.
Stamp Fairtex. The full 5-minute first round. As I said earlier, she's used to 3-minute rounds in kickboxing and Muay Thai. Had to change up the training, the cardio, the fitness level. Stamp biding her time. Roca powers through the right hand. Right hand from Stamp Fairtex. Backs off the knockout queen. Roca resets. How does she get on the inside of Fairtex? Land the hand to try to tag her on the button.
Then she's got to start circling out. She's got to get in, throw those hands, and then she's got to move out. She can't stand there because that's when Fairtex is able to lock up that clinch and start doing damage with the knees. The Stamp tries to go shin to chin.
The old 3-2, a classic boxing combination against the boxing champion. Roca tucking her chin. Fairtex looks for the inside lead thumb. Good right hand there from Stamp Fairtex. Jab 2 from Roca. Stamp goes to the legs. One way to slow down the boxing of Roca is to take out her legs. Top-thumping leg kick from Stamp Fairtex. The Muay Thai and kickboxing world champion. Showing all the weapons available to her. Flex the leg again to Stamp Fairtex. They're going to take their toll on Roca. Hitting that common perennial nerve just above the lead knee of Roca. It's designed to get in the leg. Jab 2 from Roca. Stamp smiles at her. Patience here from Stamp Fairtex Dragon.
She's doing is touching up that inside leg, trying to earn some dividends here in the second round, because when she just keeps touching that leg, because you can see this movement coming from Roca, just constantly circling to her right. Stamp doesn't really get too close with the range. All she's doing is touching up that leg. when Roca closes that distance and starts to flurry with the hands, that's when Stamp's able to answer. She's not too concerned too much with closing the distance or really changing her tactics here, just doing the lands.
36 left. Stamp Fairtex is the queen of kickboxing, the queen of Muay Thai. But the mixed martial arts queen of the Atomweight division is Angela Lee. She'll be watching this one at the moment, Angela Lee.
Luka's got to be careful. She reaches for some of those outside leg kicks and exposes the side of her head just like that. Stamp goes high.
Oh, look at the torque. Look at the pivot. As Stamp Fairtex thunders in these roundhouse kicks.
Start to see a little bit of that superficial damage on the thighs there. You can see how that, you can see that left leg of her.
And the confidence, Mitch. She doesn't go straight back to her corner. She takes a moment to dance for this sold-out audience.
Gotta love the Stamp dance, Michael Cervello. Here's a little bit of work. That was the kind of the, you know, Roca moving forward, throwing the hands, and Stamp, the only time she's really initiating any big exchanges is after Roca throws.
As is our sellout crowd. Stamp Fairtex, two-sport world champion, Asha Roca, national boxing champion of India. Third and final round. There's a lot for Asha Roca to do. She's got to find a way to get on the inside and land the leather on the jaw, on the body of Stamp Fairtex.
All right, ready?
Olivia Cost gets us underway inside the one championship circle. Jab two from Roca. That's a better start from the Indian. High man, the Muay Thai quick from Stamp Fairtex. A barrage of knees from Stamp.
Stamp's going to spin her to the left here. Puts her on her back.
Oh, Meltzer again! And she did it easily. Now can she posture up? You can see Asha Roca holding down the head, holding down the left arm. Now holding both arms. Now they're both free. Elbow from Fairtex. Melted her twice in the first round. Already here in the third and final round. Is Roca going to give up her back?
She's giving up that arm, though. See how she extends that arm when she's trying to push away from Stamp Fairtex? That arm might as well have a bow on it.
Elbow. Another one. Between the eyes of Asha Roca. Now she gets up her back. Stamp Fairtex softens her up. Roca with no place to go. Stamp's going to try and choke her out. This is the beginning of the end. Roca trying to defend. Stamp Fairtex attached to her back. And a long time to go here. Plenty of time for Stamp. Defense against Alma Juniku. Michael Cervello, Mitch Chilson with you. This one brought to you by Shanghai Media Group. Look out for the power in the hands of Stamp Fairtex in these 4 ounce gloves. There is no margin for error. Superb Thai technique on Alma Juniku.
Bright lights do not seem to get into Alma Juniku. She seems very calm, very relaxed, excited to be in there.
And Alma's competed in China here before. She knows what it's about, a two-time world champion. Stamp Fairtex's first time in China. Has won on the road before, of course. She won in Singapore against Janet Tai. Outside leg kick from Juniku. The Australian in the pink trunks. The Thai in the black and white. High kick to a right hand there from Stamp Fairtex.
See a very long high guard from Juniku. Let's see how she uses, like, her body's almost curled away so she can avoid those body kicks.
In her one Super Series career so far, Stamp Fairtex has not competed against anyone as well-credentialed as Alma Juniku.
She's just 18, Michael. She's so young. She's got so much road ahead of her.
So nice too, Stamp Fairtex, only 21 years old.
Go!
Jab there from Alma. Scott Moss giving her instructions in her corner. Prem Fairtex in the corner of Stamp. Patient start from both these women. front kick from Alma. Counter right roundhouse kick there from the champion, Stamp Fairtex.
Beautiful evasion there of the push kick to land a body kick by Stamp Fairtex.
Chain two and a roundhouse kick tucks it on the left arm of Alma Juniku.
Alma's got to be a little bit more aggressive. She can't let Stamp get off like this.
Some Australians in the audience here tonight at the Bouts. Guards from both of these ladies. Very long legs on Alma Juniku from Queensland, Australia, up north. Nice threading knee there from Stamp Fairtex. Referee Atsushi Onari calls for it.
Alma does have a 6-centimeter height advantage. And it looks like it's all in her legs.
Now you are allowed to grapple to clinch under these Muay Thai rules, but while in the clinch, you've got to stay busy. Three judges ringside are scoring on a 10-point must system. Give the winner of the round 10 points, the less dominant boxer gets 9 points. So wherever you're watching in 140 countries plus around the world, get out your notepad and pen. Give someone 10, give someone 9 after one round. It's our main event of One Championship Legend Request live from Shanghai, China.
Good first round by both these women. That was that straight right hand. That was the best punch of the round, slicing right through the guard of Juniku. And then she lands that body kick. That seems to be her game plan for this one. She wants to throw the hands, 2-3 punch combinations, and then finish with a kick. That's usually Unica's MMO. She likes to throw the body kick. She likes to throw the hands, finish with the kicks. But Stamp Fairtex is starting to do that. We haven't even seen Stamp enter the clinch yet. We haven't seen her work and start working the dumps. She's just playing Alma Unica's game.
How you feeling?
Okay, out.
All smiles in the corner of 18-year-old phenom Alma Juniku, a 2-time world champion, against another 2-time world champion in Stamp Fairtex. Sparkling, glittering crowds. The Bouts Arena in the world's biggest city, Shanghai. Orthodox stances on both of these incredible athletes. Over 130 martial arts world champions on the One Championship roster. You're seeing two of them in the ring right now. Fairtex cracks away to the upper up ribs. Looking for a sweet takedown there was Alma Juniku. Juniku's heritage from Albania. Stamp Fairtex, who grew up in rural Thailand. A real rags to riches story. Nice jab to them from Juniku.
Like the jab of Juniku. It's really finding a home on the chin of
Fairtex. Kick to the outside lead thigh from Stamp Fairtex. Front kick to the midsection from Juniku. Right hand lead to an outside leg kick. Tenderizing that quadriceps area is the champion, Fairtex. Jab two, kangaroo from the Australian. They clinch up center of the ring. Knee there, threading nicely from Juniku. And referee Onari calls break.
Go!
Yunuku's handling herself very well inside that clinch. She's got her body positioned down. She's avoiding all the dumps.
Nicely done from Alma Juniku.
That's the second time the Stamp's been put down on her butt by catching that leg kick and throwing those hands.
Checks the inside leg kick, Juniku. Look how tight and high the guard is on Alma Juniku. Her corner telling her to keep the gloves up. Stamp looks for the counter right hand. Throws a roundhouse kick off the back leg. 1:10 remains, second round of 5. Main event here tonight. Muay Thai world title on the line. Roundhouse kick to the waist there from the champion, Stamp Fairtex.
At least in the first two rounds, we're not seeing a lot of counter striking. We're seeing whoever goes first, they're the one that's scoring.
You know that Stamp and the entire crew at Team Fairtex have studied a lot of footage of Alma Juniku. Tremendous respect shown for the talent, the technique, the strategy of Juniku and her coach Scott Moss. Usually we do see Stamp open up very heavy on her opponents, not so tonight, a more cerebral contest. Just see the shink in the Australian's armor. jab from Juniku. No right hand for company. Gets off the ropes to Fairtex.
Good parry there from Stamp Fairtex.
Capture right hand from Fairtex. Goes to the outside guy. Kicks now from Juniku. Brings a knee up to the right rib cage. Elbow from Stamp Fairtex. Uppercut elbow from Fairtex. Second round almost in the books here. We're going into the third. Wherever you're watching, folks, 140 countries around the world. Hope you're enjoying it. Big hello to all of our fans in Thailand. Watch on Thai TV, channel 32. Who do you score it for so far, folks? Do you have it, Stamp Fairtex? Do you have it for Alma Juniku?
I'm going to throw the question back at you. How do you have it?
Mitch, I can't separate them after two rounds, but I will say this. The judges at the end of five, no matter how close this is, in one super series, there are no draws. There's no extension round. We must have a decision.
Now, those are two very close rounds. I mean, we're seeing that nobody's really taking advantage. Nobody's scoring really clean shots. The only clean shot that was landed was in the first. That second round was very close. Alma Juniku has put down on basically like a trip takedown with the right hand landed, so nobody's scoring effectively. It's very close these first two rounds.
It's a marvelous sight here in Shanghai, China, the Baoshan Arena, for one championship legendary quest's main event. And now I get the feeling we may see the aggressive meter rise. We may see the mercury, the intensity rise. Third round of five.
Go!
We have to see them turn it up right now. Nice jab landed by Juniku. Let's see if she can put together some jabs.
Counter right hand from Juniku. Trying to backstab into the corner. Cross out across the face there from Stamp Fairtex.
That little turn that she's doing right there inside the clinch is really controlling Stamp very well. She's not going face to face. She's not going chest to chest with Stamp Fairtex. She's angling her body, and Stamp's not able to turn and dump her.
On the inside, Alma Juniku looking confident. Good knee to the bread basket there from Stamp Fairtex. Alma negates them, glances over to her corner. Scott Moss giving instructions. Dances back to centering the Australian. Sticks a jab in the face. There's a right hand. Nicely done from Juniku. Jab from Juniku, no right hand on that occasion. Stamp's got to pick up the pace here. There's a right hand from Fairtex.
That jab's working for Juniku. Likes to hear following up with the kicks. That's what she's been doing. She's just falling into the hands.
Look up at the big screen to see how much time's remaining. Just past the halfway point of this third of five. Outside leg kick from the Australian. Jab Juniku, right cross counter there from Stamp Fairtex.
You called Juniku a phenom, and she's got experience well beyond her years. A phenom might be a good description of this young lady.
18 years old, two-time world champion. I guess another two-time world champion. What's the headbutt of Stamp Fairtex? How about that?
Beautiful right hands landed by Fairtex there. You start to see the snarl develop on the face of Fairtex. She's starting to throw heat behind those punches.
Thought about the jab, but did Fairtex. Juniku stepped up the jab. Ratchet armbands around the biceps of Juniku. Spinning back elbow from the Aussie. Knees in succession from the Thai. And referee, oh no, he breaks them.
Go! She set that up. She faked the push. Spinning that elbow.
Crossing elbow from Juniku. Stamp turns her around nicely. Knee from Juniku. Puts on the knee guard to Stamp Fairtex. Good defense. Final 10 seconds. Been some fantastic periods, especially for Alma Juniku in this round.
Go!
Skips forward the Australian. Two more rounds to go. I would hate to be a judge on this one, Mitch, but I thought that was a very good round for Alma Juniku.
Yeah, I feel the same way. She was able to land that right hand effectively. She was the one pushing forward. She controlled center ring. And there's a nice right hand landed by, but it's her head movement. She's always slightly off angle. She's doing a good job of controlling that center ring, and especially inside the clinch. I'm surprised at how well she's doing by angling her body inside the clinch, so Stamp's not getting any clean techniques, and she's not utilizing that redirect dump that she's done so well in the past.
An in swell being applied below the right eye of Stamp Fairtex. Some damage from the hands of Alma Juniku. Relaxed calm in the corner of Juniku. She's been enjoying herself around Shanghai all week. Says she wants to reward herself after this contest by taking a trip to Disneyland. Why not? Fourth round of five, the penultimate round of action for the One Super Series Women's Atomweight Muay Thai World Championship, held by the lady in black and white, Stamp Fairtex of Thailand. Double right hands from Fairtex.
Nice right hand landed again by Juniku.
Fairtex has also made no secret she'd like to become a three-sport world champion. She'd like to vie for a mixed martial arts world championship somewhere down the line. Wouldn't that be amazing?
Nice.
Meanwhile,
right
though,
hand.
She's got her hands very full with Alma Juniku tonight.
She's going to have to lean on that world championship experience right now. She's going to have to turn it up.
Ready, go!
Juniku goes for the lead leg. To there from Fairtex, roundhouse kick and a clipping right. There's a stinging lead hand from Stamp Fairtex. Goes down to the bread basket. Fake from Alma, rocks the head back with a jab. Overhand right, round kick from Stamp. Scott Moss saying, staying tight with Stamp Fairtex. Keep him close, work the elbows, work the hands. Alma comes over the top with the right elbow.
By Juniku to keep Stamp inside that corner. Stamp's got to circle out. She can't allow Juniku to pressure up against that corner and keep her there.
Counter right hand from Stamp Fairtex. Outside leg kick, counter right again from Fairtex. Fairtex got to get off the ropes here. They are throwing single shots. I'd like to see some more combinations, particularly from Stamp Fairtex. When we've seen her get on song with that right hand in succession, she can be devastating.
Looks like Stamp's fighting with just a pure emotion right now. She's kind of abandoned a lot of her techniques. She's just swinging at fences.
Trying to keep her against the ropes and maybe move her to one of the corners. Low check from Stamp and a right hand. Still though, Alma Juniku controlling center ring. Stamp content to stay on the outside. Had a chance to move forward then. Trips off to her right counterclockwise. Now goes to her left into the power side of Juniku.
Stamp's starting to land though. She's trying to find some success with those hands.
Up a charge for the knees, and referee, oh no, he breaks them. Very tight contest between two world champions. Four world championship belts between them.
Great evasion there from the right hand by Juniku. Nice jab by Stamp.
The corner of Alma Juniku saying, go Alma, she's tired, take a look. One more round to go. Is Stamp Fairtex tiring? Is the champ showing fatigue?
She's got her hands on the ropes. She looks a little bit fatigued. We're usually used to seeing Stamp dance around, showboating. But Alma Juniku is right there with her. We could be two rounds apiece, Michael Schiavello.
Once again, there can be no draws in one Super Series. No extension rounds. We must have a winner.
Good. She threw the jab, avoided the retaliation from Stamp, and then landed another jab. Alma is quietly landing these shots on Stamp, and she's got her frustrated.
Rem Fairtex and the team in the corner of Stamp. Scott Moss and the team in the corner of the Australian Alma Juniku. Fifth and final round inside the sold-out Baoshan Arena in Shanghai, China. It has been a marvelous show. 3 minutes remains.
I gotta say, Michael, I'm kind of surprised. I'm a little bit bit shocked to see Juniku hanging there with Stamp Fairtex.
Atomweight, as I said, two-time world champion on paper. She presents it. The biggest set of credentials that Stamp has faced in her career, yet it's proving that here tonight in the ring.
I underestimated her. I took her age into consideration. I thought Stamp would run away with this, but Juniku is right there. Look at her control in the center ring, pushing forward. Hasn't Stamp on the back foot. How often have we seen Stamp on the back foot?
And Stamp needs to do her next. She needs to stamp her authority, stamp her place. Stamp again with Juniku. Juniku backs her up again into the corner. Not where Stamp Fairtex wants to be.
Go!
If Juniku, Alma Juniku gets the win tonight, at 18 years old, she'll be the youngest world champion in ONE history. Younger than Christian Lee, younger than Angela Lee. Such an historical context for this one. And this is Stamp Fairtex's first ever title defense of her Muay Thai crown.
Stamp's got to circle out. Now she's back in the center cage, or center ring. She's got to push forward. She's got a minute and a half here, 100 seconds to do work.
Australia has never had a ONE Super Series world champion. Thailand has had a number of them. They've been the dominant country in ONE Super Series. In kickboxing and Muay Thai. 2 seconds now remains.
Nice overhand right landed by Juniku.
Minute to win it, let's go.
Here's Scott Moss saying you're in it to win it. Let's go, Alma Juniku.
Go!
Stamp Fairtex continually on the outside. Not coming off those ropes. Now she goes with a flurry, but then she drifts backwards.
That right hand landed there to end that combination. That was a three-piece combination, and it finished with a nice little surprise.
Mitch, you know what we're also not seeing from Stamp are the roundhouse kicks. It's all boxing from Stamp Fairtex. Where are the round kicks to the legs? Where's the round kick we know she has to the head? It's just not there from the champion.
It's all hands. You gotta wonder if something wrong with her legs, is something wrong with her foot.
It's not the Stamp Fairtex we've come to know. Is there an issue with Stamp, or is Alma Juniku simply methodically picking her apart?
Landing in this round right here, so I mean, this is a very close matchup right now. It could have been 2-2, and Stamp is finding a lot of success.
Like from Stamp Fairtex.
Juniku's not putting the pedal to the metal here. She's kind of giving Stamp a little bit of a break here.
Stamp has scored some very good points in the dying stages. It's going to go down to judges. It's going to be razor close. Who takes the crown? Who takes the strap? Stamp Fairtex or Alma Juniku? Too close to call, Dragon. Too close.
Wow, what an intense battle. We're both kind of holding our breath here, waiting for the judge's decision. Juniku looked tremendous in her debut. And it was for a world title, another world title here at ONE Super Series. The bright lights did not faze her at all. She put on a tremendous performance. Is she that good, or was something off with Stamp, Michael?
A lot of questions about to be answered. That's what Stamp does so well when she catches the leg, counters with those quick succession right hands. We saw her do it amazingly against Jenna Todd. Tonight, though, let's go to Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the belt for this match, we have Chief Editor of Great Sports Media, Ms. Lee Pei Hong. And now, ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds of battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. All 3 judges have called this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, and still ONE Women's Atomweight Muay Thai World Champion, Stamp Fairtex!
Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.